In an investigation cycle, we often start out with some kind of question that we're interested in, and then we collect some data, we try to analyze that data, and then we try to make some interpretations and claims based on that data. Try to think about what we can say about that data. Sometimes we're going to say things only about the data that we have, and other times we want to try to use that data that we have to make some bigger claim or bigger inference about data that we didn't actually collect. Right? Maybe there's a bigger population.
So the whole point of statistics is that we're going to take a sample of something, look at it, infer from it, okay? So kind of this cycle, so to speak, is that you have this population that you have a question about, right? Okay, and there's some sort of question involved, all right? So how many cars from 1990s are there in the parking lot right now? Like how many people wear small shirts from Aeropostale, right? So you have all these kind of questions that actually matter. How many people, you know, are going to buy this product at Disney? You know, what's the average amount spent at a resort? Like, these are really important things to know at the Disney park, right? So there's this question that's involved, okay? Generally, it's something that you cannot think of, right? It's something that you cannot just, like, go and count it all, right? So what we're going to do is that we're going to collect some data, right? All right, we're going to take a sample. Okay, so in this class, what we've done so far is we've talked about this, right? So when you take a sample, right, what kind of samples can we do? SRS, strata, and cluster. Good. So those are those three kinds of samples. And then not only that, we just have to be careful about like how we ask questions, who we ask questions to. We want to make it completely as random as possible, right? So then what we're going to do is that we're going to look at this sample, and we're actually going to analyze it, right? Okay, and this was what we did in chapter 1 and 2, right? So how do you guys describe univariate data, one variable? Socks, right? Shapes, or shape, outlier, center, spread, good. And then with bivariate data, what do we do? DOFs, direction, outlier, form, strength, good job, strength. Awesome, okay? So really what we're gonna do is that we're gonna look at that, okay? And then we're gonna finally finish, and this is like literally the rest of this class. Like, I'm not kidding when I say you've made it to the end, okay? Because it's just gonna start repeating from here, all right? We're going to take samples, we're gonna look at them, and we're gonna do this thing called infer from them, all right? Infer. Okay, infer, all right. So, and that's kind of like where we're at, okay? We're going to use a sample to infer, right? Because just think about what statistics is, right? You want to take one sample and make a judgment call about the population, right? So that's where we're at. We're going to take one sample eventually, and we're going to make that and look at that, and that's going to tell us something about the population itself, okay?